Oh, hello. Welcome to Western Welding Academy. I was just enjoying a pipe, reading a good book about fitting. Pipe fitting. Let's go try it.
Okay, now that we're in the shop, we can get after it. Let's say some fitter brings you a hand-drawn ISO, a couple of dimensions on there, a couple of pre-cut fits. We're gonna go through the basics of fitting. We'll get into the more detailed stuff in some later videos. Minimum tools, tape measure, two hole pins, two squares. I like speed squares because they set on the pipe a little bit more flat. A hammer, got a wedge under there, and my pipe clamp. And a torpedo level. There's our minimum, that's your minimum fitter tools. That's what you have to be a welder. Even if you don't know how to do any math, look through the blue book, you gotta have this stuff. So let's get to it. I'm gonna put a 90 on there. My ISO says I gotta put a 90 on there. Little trick I start with, I bend the welding rod up so I know how this piece of pipe's supposed to go. We run north, then west, and then it looks straight up. That's what it should look like when we're all done. Okay, so you take your trusty Ultra clamp here, and it's a must have for if you don't have your fitter or your helper to help you put this stuff on. I put my clamp on top like that, then I just roll it down, and that way I got room in between them two dogs right there to make my tack. Roll her down, get her lined up on there where it'll grab that 90, not be in your way, snug her up. You take that old 90 on there, open them screws up, and you just work that baby back and forth until you get her in there the way you like it. What we're looking for is to make sure we don't have no internal misalignment, otherwise known as high-low. Don't confuse that with low-high. Low-high is a welding rod. High-low is internal misalignment. So we like her right about there. We get our gap set. Lock her down. We really don't have to do nothing with this just yet. We'll get a tack in the top, and then we'll go ahead and square off of the face to the top of the pipe. Try to always put a tack in the top, starting on top. Then we'll square it, get one on the bottom. Then we'll eyeball the sides and make sure it's on there straight side to side. So I'm gonna start on top here. Put a good 3/4 inch tack on there. Then you can pull your clamp off and you take your two squares here and you loosen that up. Now I know it's all out of level. I had a wedge under there. I'm gonna need my wedge. So you take these two squares, you set one on top, and you make sure you're on that center line right there. If you're twisted off, see how that'll roll on there. But if you're on there nice and straight, boy, look at there. We're just about right. Give that a tap downward there. That's where you need your fitter buddy to hold that down for you. Right there, I think I can hold that down when I tack it. That looks pretty good right there. Okay, it should be squared top and bottom. Oh man, look at that. That baby is in there tight. So there's a lot of debate out there about how you fit those up. Some guys like to fit it up leaning one way or the other because they believe that tack's gonna squeeze it together. And I would imagine they've had some luck doing it, otherwise they wouldn't keep doing it. I just figure, put a tack in, fit it up square, tack it, it'll stay square. Now we'll just look right down the center line of that. These little 90s, sometimes they're hard, but they'll kick off to one side or the other. Looks like that one could go that way. So I'm gonna take my wedge. We don't ever take a hammer and beat on the side of that. That's not how you do it. Use the right tool for the job. Take your spacing wedge and drive it in your gap there. So we always tack the opposite side of the wedge. Kind of common sense. Don't wanna weld your wedge in there. Thank you. And I usually three tack it, but since we're just gonna tack this up and leave it, I'll go ahead and put a fourth tack in the side here. Normally, tack the top, bottom, get the one side, and when you're running 2 inch, after you get that side, you can start on top. Run that down that other side that doesn't have a tack in it, run this side, and finish her off, and then you'll be hooking along. Okay, now, our ISO shows a couple of 90s back to back here. You hold that up there like that. One looking west and one looking up. This will be the one we just put on, the one we're looking west. We gotta make one looking west and looking up. Take our welding rod here. So we know we need one looking to one side and looking up. So however we fit that up, we'll have it turned that way. As long as this other 90's looking up, we'll be good. Now we'll go ahead and level this out. Our trusty torpedo level. A little trick you can do when you're not on flat ground. There we go. Now we're good. There. Okay, so we need to be level this way and level this way, because when we go to put that 90 on there, that side's good here. That side's good. When we go to put that 90 on there, we're gonna have to hold that level. Just like so. And that face has to match that pipe. That's why we gotta be level that way. We gotta be level this way, here, because we don't have nothing to square that to. So when we're done, we get our tack on top. Instead of using the squares, we're gonna have to use our level to straighten that up. Okay, you let me know when that's level, Rhonda. And I'm gonna move you down a little bit. Slide it down, right there. Watch that level. You got your eye on that level? Whoop.
Yep.
Come up just a little bit right there.
Go ahead, you got
slide
it.
That way right there. Okay, you level?
Go ahead.
I'm gonna tack it.
Go ahead.
Got her. Got that baby just perfect. That's where it helps to have a good hand. There she is right there. That looks good. Yeah. Yep, that looks real nice. Oh yeah, that's good. Real good. Now, like our drawing shows, we got a flange to put on there too. So now that we got our 90s oriented the right way, all we gotta do is level one up so we can two-hole our flange. Get that just right. See how that chain will pull that sucker around on you. Stick our clamp on there like we did before. Grab our flange and our two hole pins. Stick those across there. Now make sure you always two hole them, either the top two or the next two down. But if you go like that, she's going to be off 45 degrees or some dimension like that. That's why they call them two-hole pins. Always make sure you got them in two holes apart. There are some instances where you gotta have them offset like that, but only if your ISOs describe that. Now, Rhonda, I'll have you step over here. And I'm gonna have you looking right at the front of that flange. And I want you to keep that flange nice and level there. Well, you notice I leveled this 90 going that way. This flange is gonna be level. Those holes are gonna be level with that too. So when we go to bolt that up, here we go, you gotta be level. I'll holler at you when I'm ready to strike an arc here. see that bubble move when I tack that?
Yeah, it
pulls up, yep. Yep, you always end up with that. Your bubbles will move around. Good there with that. And tacks will pull on them bubbles sometimes. You just give her a little twist. There we go. Pull our clamp off. Now we're pretty well done with that. Need our squares now. Okay. Okay, Rhonda, if you want to hold one of them squares up, like hold this and right on the face of that flange right there. Now I'm just going to measure between them, find an even number. So I'm reading 4 inches here, 4 1/16 at the top of them squares. That means them squares got to come together. You need to read that. That number needs to be the same, bottom and top. So now that we're kind of done with the leveling part of it, I'm going to pull my wedge out of there. I always like these smaller squares when I'm handling 2 inch because big ones get in the way. Make sure you're touching it. So I was reading 4 inches and I was reading 4 1/8 when I should have been reading less. That square wasn't quite touching down there. Make sure your square is touching the face of that flange, top and bottom. We got 4 inches. Still about 4 1/16. Got 4 inches. 4 inches. 4 inches. 4 inches. Now you got to measure that. Tape measure's got to be parallel to the center line of the pipe because I can get it to read like 4 1/8 or 3 7/8. As long as it's parallel with the pipe, you'll get the same number, 4 inches. That's good. That's good. Let's tack it. Okay, now we'll go through the same process, except for on the sides. We got 4 inches, 4 inches, 4 inches. And I like to call out my dimensions, because if I happen to be saying something and my helper sees it different, they can let me know that I'm wrong. That looks pretty good, 4 inches all the way around. So I'm gonna tack this side and then I'll tack that side.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure you like, subscribe, share with your friends, and check out our previous video, Responding to Comments with Tyler Sassy. Hit the link below, and we'll see you on the next weld. Take care, my friends.